going, guys? Today I want to talk about keys to off-camp MMA success, or your preparation when you're not in camp, right? There's a lot of time that will be dedicated to getting you ready for an 8-week or 12-week camp. So what I wanna do is go over the key details, the objectives, and the focus points that are going to enhance your ability to prepare for in-camp training. Now, what the objective is going to be is to create a base of physical fitness, right? We wanna increase coordination, balance. You wanna increase control of every movement that we're trying to accomplish. And we wanna do that with load, okay? So we're gonna be making sure that we're getting our body prepared for the stresses that will be put upon you inside of camp. Now the focus points, again, we wanna utilize base exercises to enhance inter and intramuscular coordination. Basically meaning we wanna make sure that we're moving efficiently, utilizing our muscle and our nervous system to move weight fast, explosive, and with good technique. Right? We also want to utilize higher volumes to increase muscle mass in the right areas. And we want to make sure that we are utilizing those particular lifts and volume to increase that structural integrity, or just basically getting you armored for the work ahead, for your training. Now, a lot of times I know in MMA, you guys are training year round. So what we want to do is we want to make sure that we're enhancing the fitness, the overall GPP, or general physical preparedness, so that you can be great when you go to help your training partners when you don't have a fight lined up. Along with that, getting you prepared for when your fight comes about and you have to get into camp ready to go, all right? So again, number three is gonna be improving on mobility and end range control. Now I see a lot of guys that get fixed in those positions that are more sport specific. So what we wanna do is we wanna take that back a little bit more, and we wanna increase their overall range of motion. We wanna increase your joint integrity. We wanna increase your ability to move in end ranges and control those end ranges. And that we're gonna do with proper mobility techniques and stability movements, or I should say stability exercises, to enhance the capabilities to be strong in those end ranges, okay? Number four is gonna be increasing your overall aerobic capacity, or your ability to take in and utilize oxygen. That's gonna set up the basis of your entire energy system training, right? If you don't have a great gas tank, when you're talking about aerobic efficiency, it's gonna be very hard for you to do the things getting closer to the fight and be efficient in recovery, and also be able to push those higher limits of those threshold techniques, or whatever protocol you're using for anaerobic threshold, lactate threshold, things of that nature. But we need to make sure that we have that gas tank. We have that ability to take in, utilize that oxygen, so that you can buffer out that lactate going further inside of camp. Okay, number five, you wanna increase buffering capacity for local muscular endurance, right? We wanna make sure that we have the ability to increase that lactate and then have the ability to buffer it out going further once you start camp. Again, we wanna make sure that we are coping with the stresses put upon it, especially in the legs and the shoulders, because you're gonna be utilizing that a lot inside of a fight. So again, we're gonna be working that with lactate power training. And I go into a lot of detail on this in my new program for off-camp training. It's partnered with Train Heroic, so you guys can check it out in the link in the description. One of the best programs I've actually written, and the things that I utilize for a lot of my fighters for off-camp training, going into a camp, getting them prepared for the stresses of an 8-week camp. So check it out in the link in the description. All right, so now we're gonna go into the exercises and some of the protocols that I like to utilize to help enhance the capabilities, or prepare the athlete for an in-camp training. Let's do it. So now I'm gonna give you two protocols that you can use to help increase your GPP, or your general physical preparedness. Now, if you guys follow me in the past, you know that I like to do a lot of sled drag variations. So what I did inside of the program that you can get now in the link in the description, it's an off-camp program from Train Heroic. We partnered up. Again, I can't stress this enough. This is vital if you're trying to increase your ability to do work for a longer time to help you get into camp. But again, here we go. So the first one we're gonna do for general physical preparedness is gonna be a sled drag variation, or a couple of variations that you can utilize. The protocol, again, you're basically trying to increase strength and fast twitch capacity, all right? So again, your fast twitch muscle fibers, the explosive muscle, that's what we wanna use when we go to propel ourselves forward, or pull or push the sled down a particular distance. Now for the distance, I like to utilize first 40 to 60 yards, give or take. Now, you're gonna do this in a 3-week pendulum wave, right? You're gonna wave up the entire volume, or you can wave up the weight. Now, I like to start off with right around 70%. of your body weight on the sled. Now you can wave yourself back up, so you can go 70, 80, 90% and then wave back down from a loading perspective, or you can keep it at 70% and then increase the sets. So instead of doing four sets, you do four sets, six sets, eight sets, and then wave back down, increasing the load over time, okay? So again, 40 to 60 yards, 70% to roughly 90% effort or 90% of your body weight. And then if you get really strong enough and you can understand how to move efficiently without any, you know, fumbling around or moving side to side or anything like that, then you can start to do 100% of your own body weight when you're talking about going forward and backwards. It's a little difficult going sideways. Again, you want to stay lower on that range, probably 60 to 70% of your body weight. But again, if you can get stronger over time, you can start to increase even over your own body weight. And that's really when you're starting to see your body start to take into what we're doing with the sled drags, which is basically gaining that strength with a very simple movement pattern. So again, three times per week, all right? And you wanna rest every time you get to that 60 yards, you're gonna rest about 90% recovery. So again, you wanna be able to bring your heart rate down roughly about, you know, 110 to 120 beats per minute, or just enough to where you're back to nasal breathing only. And again, you're ready to go with high force throughout that entire distance, okay? So the example that we're gonna do for the first one, this is for the lower body. You can do sled drags going forward. Now, when you walk forward, however, you want to make sure you're keeping an upright posture, and we're actually going to pull our body forward with our hamstrings. So you're going to go heel toe walks, pulling your body forward with the hamstrings, making sure you're not leaning and using your quads to propel yourself forward. This is primarily a posterior chain movement or exercise. Again, four sets or six sets, depending on where you're at. 60 yards total, 90% recovery in between each set, okay? The second thing you're gonna do is a sled drag backwards. Now this one, you're gonna sit back into almost like a back pedal position, and I don't want you leaning back, utilizing your weight to help you pull the sled. You wanna sit your hips down, right? And then you're gonna utilize your quads going toe to heel on the pushback, and again, 4 by 60 yards there. The last one you're gonna do is a sled drag side shuffle. So this one, you're gonna pull the slack all the way out, and then you're gonna push sideways, right? So you're gonna get that lateral force displacement, and you're gonna repeat that again for two trips of 60 yards. So you're gonna go back one way or down one way, back the other way, down again, back again, okay? So that'd be two sets total, right, on each side, okay? Now for the upper body, right, the example that I like to utilize, I like to go in a flow pattern, right? Because again, I'm trying to get as much work in. So we're talking about the entire workload as a whole, and we want to increase the density of the training. So we're going to go sled rows for 5 minutes, and you're going to do one rep of sled rows and then one rep of face pulls, and that's going to be 5 minutes total, okay? So you're going to go row into a high pull or a face pull, back and forth. For distance, again, this can be 60 yards, it can be however long you want it, because it is gonna be for a time duration. So now you got 5 minutes total there, and you can wave that up too as well, going 5 minutes, 8 minutes, 10 minutes, then increase the load, wave back down to 5 minutes, okay? The second thing for the upper body is going to be sled press. So that's just basically a punch pattern or a press pattern. And then a sled tricep extension. Again, for MMA in general, we want to increase the ability to extend and lock out the arm, okay? Because that's going to help with the end range of the punch. So if we can work the soft tissue there, we can work the muscle there too as well. That's gonna enhance our quality of performance, but also mitigate the risk of injury and soft tissue damage or any type of tendonitis that flares up because of monster, you know, hitting the pads, hitting the bag on a constant basis. So that helps too as well. Again, we're gonna go 5 minutes, so it's gonna be back and forth, a chest press and extension, 5 minutes total. Again, you can wave that up and down too as well, all right? Now, as far as the conditioning goes, and again, we're priming the soft tissue for higher levels of plyometric and power metric and explosive power movements and jumps. We're gonna do something called aerobic plyometrics. Now, what that does is it improves on the endurance of the fast switch fibers, just like we're kind of doing here in the sled drags, but now we're using jumping or ballistic style motions, all right? It's gonna improve the elasticity of the soft tissue. Again, if we can improve that elasticity, we can get a better stretch reflex to help with that fast amortization phase, to help with plyometric, and also increasing the explosive power in the long run, okay? So for overall protocol, you can go 8 to 12 bounds or jumps or throws, right? And we wanna make sure they're fast and reactive. You're gonna do 20 seconds to 30 seconds even of rest if you need it, okay? And then basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna do that at least 5 to 10 times, all right? So you got 5 to 10 sets, all right? Again, 8 to 12 bounds or throws. And then some of the things that you can do, again, is a hurdle hop, a low box jump, med ball reaction throws on the wall or on the floor, okay? You wanna make sure, again, that you're doing a fast amortization phase. So again, that time when you hit the ground and redirect force has to be fast, right? You can't stay on the ground for too long because that wouldn't be plyometric. So again, we're increasing that, but we're maintaining an aerobic zone. So we're maintaining a heart rate at a lower range so that we can get, again, the more benefit from a mitochondrial density standpoint of the fast switch fibers, basically meaning we're increasing the aerobic capacity of those higher intensity movements, and also the muscle fibers needed for that explosive movement. So again, that's what we like to do, getting the body primed, getting the body ready, increasing that base, and getting you ready for the other higher level movements ahead inside of camp, okay? So again, like I said, these two protocols are in my new program that is partnered with Train Heroic. You can get the app now, the off-camp MMA program. It's 22 weeks long, and I'll be going over it with you guys on a weekly basis and answering your questions there. So again, I urge you to check it out in the description below. If you like this video, you know what to do. Hit the comments down below. If you have any questions, notification, hit the bell. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't done so, and I'll see you again next time. Peace.